Hello YouTube, what's up? Truly a great day for me because I wanted to show you my recent pickups when I went to Paris last month. So one of the things that I had in my agenda was to go and visit few of the comic book shops around and find some good pickups. So I went to this shop called Pulps Comics in Paris and was super excited to find a lot of comics there, which you don't get, you don't get it in India, the single issues. So I was going through the stack and I came across this True Believers, which just got launched the week in which I was there in Paris, and luckily for me. And the best part about this, these are comics which are priced at $1, as you can see. It's a $1 issue. There it was €1. They were charging a single euro for a book instead of a dollar, which is more expensive, by the way. But super stoked. Wanted to show you off this amazing haul. For example, see this one, the Wolverine Evolution. You could see Sabretooth and Wolverine matching against each other. You could see the sheen on this book, right? You don't get it in India. The new ones right off the print, right off the printing press, right? So I was very, very happy to get this into my collection. Planning to bag them after this video and keep it safe. So opening up, you will start seeing some amazing graphics, right? I'm sorry for the glare in this, but some amazing graphics if you look at it inside. I hope that's better. Right, Wolverine looks super awesome in here. So just taking you through some of the inside pages for you to get an idea of how great these comic books are. Right. Of course, there is a fight between Sabretooth and Wolverine in here, as you can see. Wolverine walks up right into the X-Men mansion and starts fighting Sabretooth. Right. I forgot the story. I read it the day I returned from Europe. I read this book, so I don't remember the story anymore. But it's a start of a run. I wanted to get this one too, but unfortunately, it was not there when I went. But as you could see, awesome fight scenes there, right? Sabretooth looks very, very, I feel he's one of the best villains they could create against Wolverine, right? And the ending page has this amazing cover art when they both face each other, and it's a two-page run, as you can see. Right, so super amazing book. This is one part where I wish I was actually living in a country where the comics comes out every week. Unfortunately, that's one thing that doesn't happen in India. Another one which I picked up is True Believers number one, Venom Shiver. Again, another awesome cover. Venom is gaining popularity a lot these days, as you all would know. And even I saw some pop figures also now having the Venom editions. There are Venom Lokis, Venom Spider-Man, all kinds of Venomized pops around. So this is a different story of Venom and its origin. Right. Again, I forgot the entire story, but as you can see, the graphics are amazing. Right, this happens somewhere in the Arctic or Antarctica, where a sort of set of scientists start turning out to be dead, and I think Venom is behind it. So it's a different storyline altogether. Right, so that's the book. So any of you, if you get a chance, do pick out this True Believers series. I think it's good value for buy. You get super amazing comics and it's a single dollar each. So I picked up quite a few. The next one I have is Wolverine versus Sabretooth. No guesses, my favorite character in Marvel Universe is Wolverine. Like in DC, it's Batman. So I have here, this is a book. See, many of these True Believers books are based upon the most famous runs that these characters have had over the years. So it's like a reboot by the Marvel Universe, right? As you can see, these are the coloring, the printing, everything is in the same style in which it had come out all the time back, long back, right? So this is another story. I forgot what exactly the story was, but again, it is something to do with both Wolverine and Sabretooth and them facing out against each other. As you can see, they fall down from a cliff. I would definitely need to read it once again before I back them up, right? But great book, must have. If you happen to get a chance to pick them up, do pick them. So that is Wolverine versus Sabretooth. Next up is, of course, the Infinity Gauntlet, number one. Again, True Believers number one. Simply picked it up for the cover. I am yet to read it. I'm yet to read through many of my comics now. I've been lagging behind on them, but super awesome cover. What can you say about that? Like, you could see everything all in one shot. This is a cover I wanted very, very badly, and to get it in a single issue is like a dream come true, right? So I've not read it. I am planning to read it. I'll read it tonight itself. But it's the story of the Gauntlet, I believe, and it has a lot of characters, some of whom I have no idea about. But the good part about this book is it is bigger than the other books which I've showed you so far. It has much more number of pages. I'm estimating it should be have around 50, 60 pages. So obviously you get more story out of it. Again, this is also a reboot of the Infinity Gauntlet from all those years back. As you can see, all sort of characters come to life here. So, I mean, there's no question. This will definitely be a pickup for you if you get a chance. I was lucky enough to be there in Europe. Interesting to see Doctor Strange with the very strong mustache there. But anyways, definitely need to go through this book and read about it, the Infinity Gauntlet. But very happy, happy to own this. Definite read today night, and then it's time to bag it up. Next one I have, obviously, again Wolverine. This one is Wolverine Fatal Attractions. Him being one of my favorite characters, I just went berserk and picked up every True Believers which had Wolverine name in it. Although now I feel that I should have picked up more books on other characters also, because I saw that there was one about Daredevil. Like, you see, you could see the other number ones, right? Daredevil was also there. I didn't pick it up. Now I'm feeling bad that I didn't, and I should have picked it up. But any case, so this is another storyline. Very, sh it's a, it should be a big hit then, which has again got a reboot here, right? I'm sure most of you guys watching would know about these things much better than I, because recently I was reading more of DC than Marvel, so I am kind of lost on a lot of stories and a lot of happenings in between. So I need a lot of catching up to do in Marvel Universe. But anyways, the book is awesome, and obviously X-Men along with Wolverine makes everything great. So that's it, guys. So this is Wolverine Fatal Attractions. Next up is Wolverine versus Venom. Couldn't leave it behind after I saw it. Two of my favorite characters battling out each other, right? Again, I don't know. Like, if I start grading these books, I would grade it above 9, but maybe I'm not the right person to grade it. But right, it feels so fresh, right off the a comic book shelf, new as ever. So again, this is another story of how Venom and Wolverine came face to face with each other. I remember some part of about this story that Venom was super scared of Wolverine, and somewhere before this he had beaten Venom, so he is super scared about it. And then some other character enters the scene, and Venom chases him out. Wolverine follows him. So, right, Sarah, there are some interesting characters in here, and but some great artwork. So I'm just running you through the pages for you to get a snapshot of what is going on here. But anyways, another super awesome book. The last of my true believers is Venom Toxin, right? Most of my pickups has been Venom and Wolverine. So it's a very nice cover with these bullets representing some hideous creatures there, right? So it talks about another story. I mean, I really like this Venomized number one. I wish it was also there when I had gone, and I would have definitely picked it up. I'm actually now wondering, like, I don't know how many I would have picked up, right? If I had the opportunity, and how many books I would be owning by now, because I'm becoming more and more of a hardcore comic book fan day by day. My collection has grown leaps and bounds now that I don't have space to store them all. So it's becoming kind of like a hassle for me. So really happy to be back in the comic book universe, and reading all this kind of stuff opens up a really totally different world outside of your normal routines, right? Some great artwork here. Look at that. Wow. So that is the last book I have from True Believers. I am planning to show you some more stuff in my subsequent videos, but I wanted to create a video specifically for True Believers, and so this is my collection on that. So guys, thanks for watching, and see you next time. Please do subscribe, please do like my videos. It would be extremely supportive if more of you guys can watch and subscribe, and it gives me a lot of enthusiasm to create more of such stuff. And thanks for watching, guys. Bye bye.